Have you ever seen a crystal before? Crystals are super cool formations found in nature. Fact, when liquids cool and then harden, they might form crystals. Little molecules form together in repeating patterns to make a crystal. Some amazing examples include liquid magma that cools slowly, crystals like quartz or geode, and even extra fancy crystals like diamonds. We can even make some amazing artwork now that we know how crystals form. Here's what you'll need to do it. Epsom salt, water, food coloring, measuring spoons, craft sticks, ice cube tray, or a muffin tin. You'll also need some cardstock or sturdy paper and paintbrush. Start by making your paint. For each color, combine about 1/2 teaspoon of Epsom salt with 1/2 tablespoon water in your ice cube tray or tin. I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon for every little cube tray thing that I want a color in. I'm gonna add 1/2 tablespoon of water now. Add a few drops of food coloring to create your colors. It's mixing the colors. Why am I doing the colors mixing? Now may be a good time to mention that this craft is kind of messy, so you might want to lay your area down with some paper, which I have already done, as you can see. Okay, now time to channel your inner artist. Use these paints like you would use any other paints. The more you paint on them, the more crystals will form. I'm just gonna do a pattern here because... Ooh. Ooh, maybe I'll just do like a sea. Sea creature. Okay, I'm just gonna keep painting. It's taking a long time. It'll probably sell for 1,000,000 gems, if you know what I mean. Let your paper dry for at least a day. Hallelujah, my name is not spelled good. Leave your paper to dry for about 24 hours, or a day to be exact. And then you can check out the awesome crystal formations. Ooh, it's already getting like shiny. Here are some that I made last night. These crystals are possum. Ah, they're getting stuff all over them. You might even say that this art totally rocks. For more fun ideas like this, visit animaljam.com and don't forget to play wild.